Well, now we're going to install the crank. This, in this case, it's a dub crank. And first thing we want to do is install these. And you guys are going to love this because I get more questions about grease than anything else. And I can tell you right now, you're allowed to grease stuff. You're going to love this. No problem at all, right? The reason why I like to use the grease is because in this case, it allows these to stay in place just like that, kind of like a little glue. So once again, you're just using a little smear in there. Now these are the dub road rings right here. We're gonna install them. You can also put a little smear grease on there if you like. Follow the directions, but you will see that the skinny one goes in the non-drive side and the one with the offset built into it goes on the drive side. And as you can see, this has a TruDrive sleeve in it. So we want to go ahead and, now this is actually, this lip is gonna catch the TruDrive sleeve. So when we push this in, we need to push the TruDrive sleeve up into position, just like that, and then that'll push in, boom, just like that. So you see how it captures that TruDrive sleeve right inside of there. So now let's go ahead and install the crank. Once again, you can use a little bit of grease, and we can either put a little bit on the crank itself if you want, or you can put it on the inside of the bushings. Really doesn't matter. So right on there. And we always want to do the splines on this. Now in our instructions, we give you a link to the actual SRAM official instructions for installing the dub cranks right here. By all means, we want you to follow those. That's all I'm doing right now. I am just following the SRAM instructions. All you have to do is bolt the crank arm on and torque it down. All right, now as I snug this right here, I'm gonna do a final torque in just a second, but I always like to do as I'm assembling any crank set, I always like to spin it intermediately as I'm doing these different steps just to make sure everything is still functioning as it should be. And as you can see, it's functioning pretty well. I'm gonna torque this to the spec that is actually laser etched on the crank fixing bolt itself. And I have to tell you, it's 54 Newton meters in this case. Always pay attention to what it's supposed to be. And I gotta tell you, that's actually about 38 foot-pounds. That's a lot of torque. That puppy ain't coming off. What some of you will notice is that our flange on our T47 is actually smaller than a lot of the ones that are being used by, well, by SRAM and some others. Because we had a problem with this ring inside these SRAM dub power meters. The Quarqs in general have this backplate that can intrude onto that diameter right there, and we can have some rubbing problems. We wanted to make sure that wouldn't happen, so we went a little thinner, a little smaller here, and we ensure that that's never going to be an issue with this. So as far as setting the preload, you'll notice that I got this little back and forth action right here. That's completely normal. We want to push everything over to the non-drive side, and it's got a nifty little plus with an arrow there. It shows us which way to turn it to reduce that gap and take that up. So we're now applying preload. Now, with most systems, you want to balance the preload. That's so you don't shut the bearings down. That's not necessary with the BBInfinite system. We have the TruDrive sleeve in there. I'll link a video below that explains how that works. So what you want to do is just tighten it about as tight as you can get it, which is plastic, so don't go crazy. And then go ahead and lock this little bad boy down right here, the fixing bolt. That'll just pinch that right together right there, and we're done. So we want to do that spin test. Well, what the heck, let's do a spin test. The best spin test is what I like to call an acceleration test. See that? Let it spin itself. That's how you know the bearings are not being impinged. Okay, let's just do that big beautiful spin so we can do that before and after. So we saw the before, now let's see the after. I don't know, how long do we want this video to be? Let's spin this bad boy. Visit bbinfinite.com for our new T47 internal bottom brackets.